A program that we are incredibly excited to have a chance to share with you. My name is Paul Emerson, and I have the honor of introducing the cast of Insecurity, or Jack and Nikki Do the Cold War Tango, here leading into the Memorial Day weekend celebration for President John Fitzgerald Kennedy. And my particular note for you just at this moment is there's no right place to be and there's no wrong place to be for this particular show. Part of the premise behind this entire production is that during the Kennedy years, America and the world were on the move. And so this is a performance that's very much on the move. Things happen all the way down on the south side, on the Soviet side of the stage. They happen all the way here on the north side, on the US side of the stage. And throughout the evening, it moves all the way up and down through the grand foyer. So you should feel free to move as the performers move or move as inspires you. You can begin here, you can end there, you can find your way all the way through. On the screen that's over my head, there's video that will play of what's happening on the other side. So the south side, the Soviet side, will be shown up on the screen above, and similarly, for those of you on the south, the video screen above the south stage will be showing what's happening here on the north or US side. So on behalf of all of us from Company E and for the remarkable, incredible support we've received from the Kennedy Center, from the DC Commission, and particularly from Meg Booth and Jane Rabinowitz, we want to say thank you. We hope you will enjoy tonight's performance and that it will share some ideas, provoke some thoughts, and perhaps remind us of a time that seems long ago, but that has so many things that are relevant to the world in which we live today. Thank you very much.
The guy who gives you the eye, let him hold you tight. You can smile, every smile for the man who held your hand beneath the pale moonlight. But don't forget the thing you are, the insult you're gonna be. So darling, save the last dance for me. Oh, I know. Let the music's fine, like sparkling wine. Go and have your fun. Laugh and sing. But while we're apart, don't give your heart to anyone. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Don't you know I love you so? Can't you feel it when we touch? I will never, never let you go. I love you oh so much. You can dance, you can dance. Go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go. If he asks, if you're all alone, can he take you home? You must tell him no. Cause don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me.
Hey, 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 hey turtle was very alert. Some danger threatened him, he never got hurt. He knew just what to do. He ducked and covered. Ducked and covered.
He did what we all must learn to do.
Remember what Bert the Turtle just did, friends, because every one of us must remember to do the same thing.
Remember what to do, friends. Now tell me right out loud. What are you supposed to do when you see the flash?
Duck and cover. Duck and cover. Duck.
Of the United States.
I faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
Товарищи, дорогие друзья, граждане всего мира, я обращаюсь к вам с чувством великой радости и гордости. Впервые в истории человек с планеты Земля, наш советский человек на корабле, созданном руками советских ученых, рабочих, техников и инженеров, вырвался в космические выси и совершил первый беспримерный рейс к звездам.
Decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
Thank you. for we do not intend to leave it to others to choose and monopolize the forum and the framework of discussion. We do not intend to abandon our duty to mankind to seek a peaceful solution. As signers of the UN Charter, we shall always be prepared to discuss international problems with any and all nations that are willing to talk and listen with reason. If they have proposals, not demands, we shall hear them. If they seek genuine understanding, not concessions of our rights, we shall meet with them. We have previously indicated our readiness to remove any actual irritants in West Berlin. But the freedom of that city is not negotiable. We cannot negotiate with those who say, what's mine is mine, and what's yours is negotiable. But we are willing to consider any arrangement or treaty in Germany consistent with the maintenance of peace and freedom and with legitimate security interests of all nations. We recognize the Soviet Union's historical concern about their security in Central and Eastern Europe after a series of ravaging invasions. And we believe arrangements can be worked out which will help to meet those concerns and make it possible for both security and freedom to exist in this troubled area. For it is not the freedom of West Berlin which is abnormal, but the situation in that entire divided country. If anyone doubts the legality of our rights in Berlin, we are ready to have it submitted to international adjudication. If anyone doubts the extent to which our presence is desired by the people of West Berlin compared to East German feelings about their regime, we are ready to have that question submitted to a free vote in Berlin, and if possible, among all the German people. And let us hear at the same time from 2.5 million refugees who have fled the communist regime in East Germany. Thank you.
We'll be right back. message reaches the White House from Moscow. Chairman Khrushchev agrees to remove the Soviet missiles.
The following is the text of President Kennedy's statement of noon. I welcome Chairman Khrushchev's statesmanlike decision to stop building bases in Cuba, dismantling offensive weapons, returning them to the Soviet Union under UN verification. This is an important and constructive contribution to peace.
Пять часов утра, как всегда, пробило подъем. Молотком об рельс у штабного барака. Перерывистый звон слабо прошел сквозь стекла, намерзшие в два пальца, и скоро затих.
Thank you. W, we get off here. But watch the people move toward the doors. Watch the doors open. Watch them leave. It was mainly black people who left. He had thought that he would get off here and go home. But he watched the girl who reminded him of his sister as she moved solemnly past white people and stood for a moment on the platform before walking toward the steps. Suddenly he knew that he was never going home anymore.
And the nation which disdains the mission of art invites the fate of Robert Frost's hired man, the fate of having nothing to look backward to with pride and nothing to look forward to with hope. I look forward to a great future for America, a future in which our country will match its military strength with our moral restraint, its wealth with our wisdom, its power with our purpose. I look forward to an America which will not be afraid of grace and beauty.
Thank you. Yesterday, a shaft of light cut into the darkness. Negotiations were concluded in Moscow on a treaty to ban all nuclear tests in the atmosphere, in outer space, and underwater. For the first time, an agreement has been reached on bringing the forces of nuclear destruction under international control. Nuclear test ban negotiations have long been a symbol of East-West disagreement. If this treaty can also be a symbol, if it can symbolize the end of one era and the beginning of another, if both sides can, by this treaty, gain confidence and experience in peaceful collaboration, then this short and simple treaty may well become an historic mark in man's age-old pursuit of peace.
From Dallas, Texas, the flash, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, some 38 minutes ago.
What kind of a peace do I mean, and what kind of a peace do we seek? Not a Pax Americana, enforced on the world by American weapons of war. Not the peace of the grave or the security of the slave. I am talking about genuine peace, the kind of peace that makes life on earth worth living, the kind that enables men and nations to grow and to hope and build a better life for their children. Not merely peace for Americans, but peace for all men and women. Not merely peace in our time, but peace in all time. Our problems are man-made, therefore they can be solved by man, and man can be as big as he wants. No problem of human destiny is beyond human beings. Man's reason and spirit have often solved the seemingly unsolvable, and we believe they can do it again. For in the final analysis, our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's futures, and we are all mortal.